When I saw her, it had been, because I was living in Chicago then, and she wants to be part of the ministry, and she allowed things, I say things, to separate her from the anointing. And when she allowed things to separate her from the anointing, when I came back and saw Brother Duke, she had an incurable disease, better known as AIDS. And she saw me, and she said, "Prophet, I want to live." And his heart brings me all I can tell it was, baby, all I can do is just pray for you now, because I can't labor with you like I once labored with you in a time past. Kiss on the forehead, and I went back to Chicago. Less than a month or so, she was dead. I experienced Vic in a period of 20 some odd years in pasture. Not one member died. Not one. Not one in 20 some years. Nor anybody in the immediate family, such as a mama, a daddy, or a sister, or a brother, in 20 years. Not one. It's because we had that bond in the things of the Spirit. Not one. And after that bond was broken, less than a year, three or four of them that was in the ministry died. In a year. Folks in their family started dying. Now, it ain't about me, it ain't about me. But it's about that covenant agreement. It's about that agreement. That anointing will keep you alive.
Thank you, Lord.
That anointing will sustain you, man. You have to be careful of allowing things to get between you and that anointing. And it don't matter whether it's my fault or whose fault it is. But the separation came. And that separation came, three or four of them died. Within the same year I was gone. What did I do about it? My sheep know my voice. And since that time, I'm counting at least 10 of them is dead. But in 20 years, none of them died. That was connected and tied to the ministry. None. And I think that's a pretty good record. Give another clap. Listen, we're calling.